Hey everyone, this is Stephanie from Fast Track to Health. I am a licensed acupuncturist and functional medicine practitioner here in Southern New Jersey. Today I'm going to talk to you about ways to lower your cholesterol naturally. So before I get started, I just want to talk to you a little bit about cholesterol and what it is. Many people are afraid of cholesterol. It has been demonized through the years as being a bad, harmful substance, but it's actually a very important, vital substance that our bodies need and could not survive without. So the goal is not to get your cholesterol levels too low, because we really need them. They are precursors to all your hormones and your vitamin D and your cell membranes. So they're very, very crucial. And also, the reason that cholesterol goes to your arteries in the first place is to repair damage that's being done by inflammation. Now, the inflammation is mostly coming from an inflammatory type of diet. So what do I mean by this? I mean eating types of foods that are very inflammatory to the body. So the number one culprit in this department would be foods that are high in sugar or turn into sugar. Things like pasta, cakes, bread, cereals, crackers, cookies, donuts. These type of foods are inflammatory by nature. So your liver, will produce cholesterol in higher amounts to repair damage from the inflammation that's done by eating a lot of these type of foods. So, and it also has to do with the insulin levels that are being raised from these type of foods. So eating foods that do not stimulate insulin levels, like fats are neutral when it comes to stimulating insulin, do not cause the same type of problem. I'm not talking about all fats, but the majority of fats. So fat is not the enemy. It's basically sugar that's the enemy. So avoiding cholesterol is really not the issue. It's avoiding sugar that is the issue. So some healthy types of fats that are also beneficial are omega-3 fatty acids from foods such as wild salmon, sardines, mackerel, tuna, and things like this. So if you're eating these types of foods a few times a week, that's a great way to reduce inflammation. You can also take a supplement form of this, an fish oil supplement, making sure that it contains both EPA and DHA. So another thing that you can do is take something called coenzyme Q10. In the form of ubiquinol. Ubiquinol is the best form of it. This is also crucial if you are taking a statin medicine, to reduce your cholesterol. The statin medicine in and of itself will deplete your body of CoQ10. So it's really important that if you are taking a statin, to make sure you're also taking coenzyme Q10. So reduce the inflammation in your body by eating less sugar and starches and inflammatory types of foods, and eat anti-inflammatory foods such as things with a lot of omega-3s, and also eating more fiber, fruits, vegetables, nuts and seeds. These are your best forms of fiber, not the whole grains. That's also very beneficial. Making sure you're getting enough coenzyme Q10 is also a great thing to do. And then another thing you could do is add in herbs to your diet, anti-inflammatory herbs such as curcumin or turmeric, either eating it or taking it in a supplement form. That's also very beneficial. So making these dietary changes and supplement changes alone can go a long way in helping to keep your cholesterol working smoothly. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and please share it with someone that you know that has questions about cholesterol. And I will see you in the next video. Thanks. Take care.